Yeah, and again, that shows, that reiterates the fact that the Bilboes project is a very strong project. It's big, 2.5 million ounces of reserves and resources. It'll be producing about 1.5 million over a 10-year life of mine with a very.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me are Caledonia Mining Chief Executive Mark Learmonth, as well as Chief Financial Officer Chester Goodburn. Chester, Mark, very good to speak with you both today. So Chester, I'll start with you. You're out with your quarterly results. It's been a great quarter for the company. Can you take us through the highlights?
Yes, no, thank you, Steve, and thank you for having us. It's been a good quarter for us. Our revenues were up, costs were down, and our cash generation improved. It was good to see revenues up on account of additional ounces. So we've had more than what we planned, much higher than what we've had in the previous quarter or the comparative quarter. With higher gold prices that we've seen our revenues increase to about 35.4% quarter versus the comparative quarter. Our costs has reduced, that's in absolute terms. Our blanket mine, on-mine costs also come down quite a bit, and our cash generation has increased. And for the quarter, we've made about $12.8 million of cash on a net basis.
Mark, it's also been a strong quarter at the Blanket Mine with production of over 20,000 ounces and an update in mineral reserves and resources. Could you tell us more about that?
Yeah, the production was, as you say, was strong. We ended the quarter about 1,300 ounces ahead of target. Now, clearly, there's a long way to go towards the end of the year, but we're certainly in a very strong position. And everything kind of fell right. We were getting the right tons from the right area with the right grades and getting the right recoveries. So that was very good. And I'd like to see that continue towards the end of the year. But you're right. In May, we published a very substantial resource upgrade at Blanket Mine. And that reflects the exploration work that we started early in January 2023, and we have various drilling updates published in 23 and then earlier this year. And then that all translates into the resource update, which we published in May. And basically, we doubled our reserves, and we're now in a position where Blanket Mine has a 10-year life of mine based on reserves, including lower confidence level resources. We're confident it goes out to 2041, but it really sets Blanket up for the next 15, 16 years or so. And the increase in reserves wasn't just more tons, but it's also pleasing to see higher grade. And obviously, the best way to make more money from a mine is to have higher grade so that you get more gold in each ton that you move. So that was very rewarding and a very gratifying piece of news.
Chester, future dividends are now expected to be declared at the same time as the publication of quarterly results. Why have you made this change?
That's purely administrative, Stephen. So to coincide with our financial statement reporting dates, just reduce all the admin, additional board meetings and so forth. So nothing other than additional administration to that.
Mark, you also announced the Bilboes preliminary economic assessment in the quarter. What are the next steps there?
Yeah, and again, that reiterates the fact that the Bilboes project is a very strong project. It's big, 2.5 million ounces of reserves and resources. It'll be producing about 1.5 million over a 10-year life of mine with a very low all-in sustaining cost, below $1,000 an ounce. So that means the payback is very short. It's less than 2 years. So what we're doing now is we're now upgrading that PEA to a higher confidence level of a feasibility study. That will be done in the first quarter of next year. Then at the same time, we are now working with a London-based advisor to refine our thinking about funding, in particular the ability of the project to carry debt funding. And because it is so cash generative with such a short payback, we're confident that a high proportion of the funding can be met with debt and thereby reduce the equity dilution. So that work is ongoing, but clearly the actual converting the work on the on the debt structuring into credit-approved term sheets, that will take a little bit longer, and that really comes down to the speed at which the debt providers move, and they can be somewhat slow. I think the fundamental point is that we have a cash-generative operation at Blanket, which means that the longer we continue this, the more cash we generate from Blanket. So it's not as though we're in a situation where we need to constantly raise money to keep the lights on. We're not in that position at all.
And Mark, what's the second half of the year looking like at the moment? What can we expect from Caledonia?
I'd like to see consistency. I'd like to see a continuation of robust production, good cost control. And I think we do need to recreate the track record of delivery. And then, as I said, we'd like to see Blanket continuing with no surprises. I'd like to see the economic situation in Zimbabwe continue to be as stable as it is at the moment, which means that the incidence of foreign exchange losses has diminished, and we hope that continues. And then, as I say, early in next year, I'd like to see us publish an updated study on the Bilboes project to a higher confidence level.
Well, James, thank you very much for speaking to me today. Speaking again soon, I'm sure.
Thank you. Thank you, Stephen.
That's Caledonia Mining Chief Executive Mark Learmonth, as well as Chief Financial Officer Chester Goodburn.